What is up, guys? Chu here, bringing you another review slash reaction on Fairy Tail 100 Year Quest. I gotta say, I nearly choked up in this chapter, and I'm not gonna lie, it was a great chapter because even though it was kind of like not real, it was still nice to know where Natsu is. Unconsciously, like where he is in his mind, and I definitely hope that this is where they are, honestly, like in reality. But it was a great chapter. It was a shock to me to see some people return. But let's go ahead and get right into it, man. So we start off with his body waking up in a weird cloudy place, so it's kind of fluffy and whatnot, and so it's confirmed that we have Natsu not necessarily fully dead like he was previously in the main series, but now we have him kind of in that limbo state, like kind of like in the afterlife, you know, like that between worlds kind of thing. And the first person he sees was Xerath, and that was crazy to me to see that Xerath is the first person he sees. He's in shock to see. And then he sees Mavis, who he is so happy to. It's like, oh, you're alive. Like, no, I'm dead. And it was fun to see those two at first, and I'm like, all right. But then we got the shock that we see that they have kids. We have Art. August and Larcade. You guys remember those names. And it's like, oh my god. Like, and then Natsu's face, like, it was exactly my face. And I was kind of being teary-eyed when I read it. And I was like, man, not expecting this right now. And I was just so, in like, goodness gracious. But not only that, like, as they were talking, we get to see Igneal coming back. Like, Igneal obviously has been long gone, and we see other people, but what's really special was Natsu. Like, he was honestly really sentimental about everything here, and Xerath is talking to him, saying, you know, look, I know you won't forgive me after all. I mean, you could probably forgive me, but not everyone will. I've done a lot of horrible things, and even though we don't know where our bodies are at. And when I read that line, I was like, man, that sucks. I wish I knew that they were together in a different place. But it was crazy to see, like, how Xerath was just kind of chilling, just talking to him after everything that's happened. And he another thing was interesting was that we had Natsu asking about, you know, was Acnologia there, you know, but he didn't come in, you know. So I guess we didn't have to see that visual. But then we get to hear what Xerath is like telling him, like, look, you're in like a place that's kind of in between. We can call it the beta heaven. It's kind of like you're unconscious, but it was sad. You know, it was sad to see, like, look, you got to go back. You can't just stay here. You need to go back, and, you know, it ain't your time. And it was sad because it's like, they even tell him, like, look, you might not even remember any of this that happened. And that's okay, but you can definitely win. And we see him going away, going back to being conscious. His soul's about to be eaten, and we see that now he's like in a ghost. Like, he's able to transform his soul into a ghost, so he's now a ghost. His body is still down there, but he is able now to switch over and to actually do some damage to this other ghost slayer. And it's crazy because it's like, I wasn't expecting to see Natsu not necessarily have a new form, but be in this new state for a moment. Because we know, obviously, he's not able to do this for very long. I mean, he was told that he can do this, but he's like, and he even says, I don't remember much of what happened just now, but I felt like someone told me that I can do this. And obviously he's remembering where he was at just moments ago. But I really enjoyed this chapter. You know, things are turning around for Natsu. He's back, and he's now causing some damage. But guys, that is it for me. Hope you guys have enjoyed. If you guys have, leave a like, comment down below your thoughts. And as always, stay safe, take care of yourselves and others, and I will catch you later.